In front of me here, we've got something we're very comfortable with being part of the Conduit family. However, BS7671's on-site guide likes to throw you a curveball in how they're going to name the three in front of me here. We're very comfortable with seeing what we may call metal conduit out there in installations, maybe in underground car parks, making its way to the lighting system within there. And we might also see it on the outside of the building. And in that case, we might say this is galvanized conduit. And we may be admiring the bubble sets that electricians have put into them, or not, as the case may be. We might see PVC conduit out there in installations. We might call it plastic conduit. And we love to look at that, especially when it's done maybe a little bit averagely. Maybe it's on the outside of the building and it doesn't look as neat as possibly it could. And we might call that plastic or PVC conduit. Then we come to this one here, which is flexible conduit, or do we call it Copex because the person you work with uses a trade name of somebody who makes flexible conduit, or maybe they call it Flexicon, like the great Nick Bundy. But all of these terms are used out there on site. However, when it comes to Appendix D in the on-site guide, we need to be very careful about which ones they're talking about. As always, I've blown the page up to make it easier for us to have a look at. And as we see down here in Appendix D, this is the table here for spacings and supports of conduit. They use the following words at the top. They use rigid metal. Now, I'd like to think that if we looked at this table and we saw the words rigid metal, we'd understand that columns 2 and 3 are talking about metal conduit. Okay, that's nice and easy. Moving to the next one, we've got rigid insulated under columns 4 and 5. Rigid insulated. I always get my learners just to put the words, either pen them in. I know not everybody wants to write on their on-site guide, but actually put PVC in there. So this is the PVC conduit section. So when you're looking how often you need to put supports in PVC conduit, you're actually looking at one that's called rigid insulated. So that would go there. And then our final one, they've used the word pliable in columns 6 and 7. Pliable is suggesting to me, and you hopefully as well, that we're actually talking about flexible conduit in that section there. So it's interesting to see how the on-site guide doesn't make our life easier, yet the book is meant to be unpacking what BS7671's regulations are doing and making it easy for us as trainees and electricians. So I like to have the columns as metal, PVC, and as flexible to relate to what we've talked about in the classroom. And it's quite ironic because when you read down here in the subnotes, that actually in note number 2, a flexible conduit should be such of a length that it does not require supports throughout its run. Well, we saw flexible conduit earlier on being used to move cables around and was fixed to the fabric of the building, but they use the word flexible there, but obviously further up, they use the word pliable for that conduit system. A couple of bits I always get my students to highlight here are the maximum distance between supports of 300 mil between bends and fixing points. So where we have, say, a socket outlet or a box or a bend, we must have a support within 300 mil of that. And another one we like to highlight in this section is the minimum bending radii to be 2.5 times the diameter of the conduit. So if the conduit had a diameter of 20 mil, we multiply that by 2.5 to get a bending radii of 50 mil. So if you did a circle with a radius of 50 mil and drew it out, that would be as tight as you could put the bend in it. Well, steel conduit is actually formed by the former on the conduit bending machine, so that's not a problem to us. It's when you get to plastic conduit, and we've seen that in other videos, how to put a nice smooth bend in plastic conduit to comply to 2.5 times or greater the diameter of the conduit on the bending radius. Now, you may have seen in the corner of the camera here some of my fixings, and this table goes on to do the maximum distance between supports. And if you want to know how to work out the maximum distance, check out the video on screen over there.